throw me into the den of the tigers or what? Because I just woke up, so I don't know what's on. Is there something happened or what?
No, nothing at all.
We're just talking.
Say hello.
Yo, Aiden, add Andrew Tate too.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, wait. I actually did ask, but make him join the call.
Should I actually?
Yeah, of course. Why not?
Let me see.
You seen Aiden speak to him or something?
Let me see if he actually wants to join right now. Hold on.
Yeah, that shit was
What were your thoughts on that?
But XQ, can I say one thing? Yes, I was him, of course. But, like, the... Hold on. The thing about the girls, I didn't... But it was the afterwards, he was saying some very motivational shit.
Strategy though, it's a classic. It's an argumentative strategy where you start and you say something that's relatable and good and powerful, and then everybody's like, yeah. And as you're into that vibe, you slip in some fucking dog shit, and you're eating the dog shit because you're kind of swallowing it all up at the same time, you know. So then you're like, oh, this is really good, and then you slip some dog shit. You kind of agree with the trash afterwards without even knowing it. It's actually a strategy, man.
Okay, fair enough.
Shout out, Young Don.
The speech about the discipline really just hit home for me. I don't know.
But like Aiden, were you like going along with it? Like when he said this thing about the clown, like were you just like?
No, I wasn't going along with that point. I didn't even know what the fuck he. You know, at first I thought he was calling me a clown.
Nah, that's a heavy week.
You didn't understand what he was saying.
Not right away. It took me. I'm not gonna lie. It took who else was I talking to? It took them like a couple like seconds to hit it. It hit me like eight seconds.
I can vouch.
XQ, do you know about that?
About what?
Los Pauls, go ahead and ask him.
I forgot. What was the question?
Don't do that, Los. Ask him.
I don't know what it is. We're talking about the clown, right?
He asked, have you ever seen the gay clown that hides from gay people?
No. What is that?
You ever seen it?
You never seen the clown that hides from gay people? You never seen it?
No, I don't know what that is.
It's a clown that hides from gay people. You never seen it? Oh, shit.
I get it. Good one. I get it. That's what it is.
Omega Lows in the chat.
Bro, I don't. Why when Andrew was there, why didn't you debate him about some of the points he was saying then instead of dick riding his dumb this mess?
No point. There's no point.
What do you mean, no point?
When you go back and forth with somebody, it doesn't resolve anything. I'm just saying, my streams, listen. I don't like to argue. I don't like to politic. I don't do that. Yeah. I'll sit there and
You don't have to do that. And I hate to cut you off. Listen, bro. You can say it's not that deep, bro. If you let somebody on your stream make statements that are political in nature and let them get away with it, now it's kind of political. So yeah, it's kind of is. If you don't want to be a no politics Andy, I told him straight up.
I didn't agree with him with the take about the female driving. That's stupid as fuck to say. That's like saying, oh, and I saw what you said. That's true. Like, what if he said like a certain race couldn't drive? It's the same shit.
Stereotype. Asian people are bad drivers. I didn't know that. In Asia, we drive, we crash, we get into another car, then we continue on. Right? That's how you get from A to B. Right? What are you talking about?
With you on that part, I do, but
yes,
I'm not.
Yeah.
Well, wasn't he joking when he was saying that, though?
But
doesn't matter. It's blanket.
I'm trying to invite him right now. Hold on, I think he's.
I thought he was like completely kidding when he said shit like that. I don't know.
He probably doesn't believe half the shit he says. But
even then, though, unless the context is purely comical and shit like that, if you don't correct it somehow, it's still a blanket. People will listen in and they'll be like, "Oh, women can't drive, haha," and that's all they have. Anything else?
No. What about the thing he said about OnlyFans, where like he's like, "Oh, that's my property." Like, dude, there's no way anyone thinks that's serious.
He wasn't joking.
He was joking, bro. 100%. Bro, he said he was a trillionaire. XQ. He's not a trillionaire. He was joking about a lot of shit, bro. I'm telling you.
Dude, he's joking.
See, that's like a weird line to glide because then I can come here and say like a couple statements that are kind of crazy and wacky, man. Right now. And then I can say whatever the fuck I want for the rest of the fucking podcast or segment, right? Because I'm here for jokes and being comical. So then I can say whatever the fuck I want. I can say female this, black people that. And people say, oh, but I mean, he's joking because he joked early in the podcast. You know what I'm saying? That's kind of weird.
No, I get what you're saying.
Like if you're always in character, you could joke. But if you like if you're like in and out or like you're being real, you can't really joke like that.
You can challenge somebody's thought, right? Without making it feel uncomfortable or whatever. I get it. Maybe you don't want to do that. If you ask to clarify his take, right? And not without even fucking having a counter take, you can make him explain. Because some of the shit he said, I was like, huh? Like, if you would explain that, you wouldn't be able to articulate that, right? If you just ask, it'd be able to find, but it's okay, though.
That's so fire. He could raise an eyebrow. Like, do that again, XQ? That's crazy. I'm trying to add him in right now. Hold on.
I think it's kind of. Bro, if he comes in here, that would be crazy.
Yo, where is he based at?
Romania. Romania. He said he wakes up around 9:30. Oh, so he's probably just waking up.
It's 9:30.
Bro, isn't he like a Chad motivational lion? He wakes up at fucking
4 a.m., bro.
Yeah, he's got to wake up early, bro. Because he's got to go get on that fucking market.
Drink his black coffee and shit, bro. He's locked in.
Felix, do you like sparkling water? Nah, you don't like it.
But I don't know what's the point of sparkling the water. It's just water. But isn't he all about like mental strength and being a Chad? Like, why do you need the sparkle to remove your need to eat more food? Isn't he like in control of his thoughts? If he was so in control, he wouldn't need to get sparkle in his little water to stop eating food, man.
Nah, it sounds like he want to talk to him.
I'm trying to get him up right now.
We gotta get him to talk to him.
I guess my main question is, XQC and anybody, how would you know what his actual beliefs are? If he's playing a character,
okay. That's my like I said, it's just your feel of a combo. There's no indication. Yeah. It's just like in court, proving malice is like almost impossible. It's hard to prove malice or prove intentions. And I'm not gonna come here and say, hey, what's your name again, Apollos, man? But you said this because of that, or because of it. It's super hard, right? So you can't say it. It's just about how often he does something and how it comes by. And I think that guy, when it comes, makes statements about like women, especially, right? He comes off super strong about this shit, right? And he truly believes in that. And you can just kind of tell, like, So especially when he starts arguing, do you think he has like he has like fake rehearsed Kenner arguments and fake rehearsed statistics he pulls out to continue the troll? Or do you think he actually truly believes in that shit?
What? How do I ring him?
Where's Tate?
Oh, he declined it, so I think I gotta add him back. Oh no, wait.
It should be
in your lifetime.
I met 1,000 bitches in kindergarten. Like, Andrew! I met 1,000 girls in kindergarten, bro. Like,
oh my god! I need to get my coffee. It's upstairs. You need to give me a minute.
Andrew, hold on. Hold on. Andrew, I got it.
You hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, it's scuffed.
I hear him good. You can hear him?
So talk again.
Can everybody hear me?
Yeah, it's great.
Yeah, now it's good. Good. Now, great. Okay. Right. Get the coffee. Give me a minute.
Andrew, this is what we do, bro. That's what we do now.
Oh, it's like that now.
It's what we do now, bro. Come on now.
You got to back up, bro. Back up a little, bro. Back up.
How are you, my friend? You good?
I'm good. So who are all these people? We got a bunch of people here.
All right, QC. He's the one who said he's going to get his coffee. He doesn't agree with a lot of your takes. XQC is currently number one ranked on Twitch, so he's the biggest streamer. So he just doesn't agree with a lot of your takes. He thinks I'll let him speak, but you know, you're still top. You're still top G to me though.
I'll always be top G.
Oh, get off his dig, bro. Get off. I'll always be top G. Bro. Don't do that.
Hey, this nigga got you hypnotized, huh, boy?
Yes, he does, and I'm happy with it. Bro. Look at him, bro. How could you not be like, damn? You know what I mean?
Oh my god, yo, he's going crazy.
Hey, wash my hands, and I'm good.
He's gotta wash his hands.
Wait, I think XQC is nervous.
He is.
Yo, look at Chris.
You gotta get coffee. You gotta go pee.
Right,
you gotta wash
right,
his hands.
Right, he's really gotta lock in. What the fuck?
Nah, he's wiping his hands. Oh, nah, he's getting ready. He's getting ready.
This guy more of a top G than somebody else. Look, he's here right now. What, top G of what?
Oh shit, Los, you ready?
Oh my god, I don't know. It's a mistake, bro.
Wait, what were you saying, X? Repeat that.
Yeah, what were you saying?
I said the top G of what?
Oh no.
What is, no.
What is Tate the top G of what?
Hello?
Question. What's up? These people say you're the top G. The top G of what? Can we get a rundown first, an introduction?
I'm back at the right time. Hopefully I don't have any internet issues. It seems for some reason my internet's a bit slow, so let me know if it cuts in and out.
I broke internet.
Yeah, top G of broke internet.
Mod, two predictions, who's going to win? XQC
or I don't think, I don't really feel, my friend, like I'm compelled to justify myself to you. If I
Let me start with introductions first. Where are you from? What country?
Are you talking to me?
Yes.
Oh, shit.
This whole panel feels strange. I don't know.
I'm trying to pinpoint the accent.
The energy is tense.
Yeah,
South African.
It's kind of like I've walked into a police interview. You know, it's weird.
That's why I said to Aiden, I said, "Be careful when you bring him in. He might feel like he's getting ambushed."
Yeah, it's a weird thing because obviously Twitch is an online community, right? But I live in the real world. I'm not from this internet world. And in the real world, you talk to people, especially people who can destroy you, with respect. You say, "Oh, Andrew, can you please introduce yourself?" You don't come and say, "Hey, bro," it's just an internet. It's weird.
Wait, what do you mean by destroy? Like, what do you
mean by, like, beat his ass or if you mentally destroy?
Men go through and talk to each other with respect. I think that's how men
interact with each other. Yeah,
but in my opinion, wouldn't you say that a respect between two men would be not making me be formal and you would just understand what I mean, right? You would just get what I mean, right? When I say, "Yo, man, where are you from?" Like, you don't even say, "Hello, sir. Can you please tell me where you're from, sir?" Is that what you need?
No, I think that being polite and being formal is something you do.
I was being polite. I softened my voice and I said, "Hey, man, where are you from?" Try and pinpoint the accent.
Okay, well, that's not how it sounded. It said, "Hey, stop. Tell me where you're from." So
well, I have a deep voice, so people take it the wrong way very often.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, it's a thing. He gets people getting real mad at him for that.
Just some advice for the real world. Anyway.
I have 1 foot in the real world, brother.
Only one?
Only one. 1 foot in, 1 foot out.
I'm half British, and I am half American. That's why the accent is.
It's like South American?
No. American.
Bro, chat, chill, okay, bro. So I'm not kicking train, bro.
I was born in the United Kingdom, but I've been back and forth between the two countries my whole life.
Okay, fair enough.
Okay. So that's the introduction. Andrew Tate is my name, everybody. Nice to meet you all.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Remember everything. Aiden messaged me and said, "Andrew, quickly wake up. Someone disagrees with you." That's what
okay, a good introduction, because that's it. That's how it is.
Who disagrees with me and on what?
I think I disagree with most things, but I think, I don't know about Train though. I don't think he knows you that much. All I saw is a couple clips of you, and I didn't want Wikipedia whole search. I wanted to take the arguments and the takes, what they are, and not where they come from or whatever. Just straight up, face value. That's what you get.
You have something specific you disagree with me on?
Oh yeah, most of your women takes are bad.
Yeah, but you have to be specific because the burden of proof is on you. So.
Oh no, literally most of them.
Oh yeah, but you can't say literally most of them. This is a court of law, my friend. We have a judging panel and everything. You have to come along with the take that you disagree with and give your argument as to why it's not true. You can't just
woman
say.
Woman can't drive.
Woman can't drive was one of them. Yeah, that was kind of weird.
So you don't think that men are overall better drivers than women?
No.
So when you see the worst parking you've ever seen in your life, you don't think it's more likely to be a female?
Yo,
it's just as equally likely to be a man in your view.
Crazy, bro.
Well, I mean, when I see, exactly what you said. Yes.
Then that's your opinion. What's the argument?
You know, like I said, it's not. It doesn't have to be an opinion, right? That's at least your anecdotal evidence, which is like kind of a bias, right? When you want to bring out things like women can't drive, you're gonna go with stats, and your stats are off. You're just wrong about them. Don't look at me, look at the people next to you. That's not diamond, we're trying to wheel. Pull over the hell over.
Don't touch nothing. Just don't. You can't negotiate turns, you can't signal properly, you can't maintain speed, you can't parallel park. Hell, you can't drive, honey. Shit, I can't swim, I know I can't. So you know what I do? I stay my black ass out the pool. All right, now, just take it around the block a couple of times, okay? All right.
Well, everyone is, firstly, when you talk about biases, absolutely everybody is biased to their own personal experiences, right? If I've been in 5 car crashes and all 5 of them were driven by women by coincidence, I'm going to be biased. I'm going to believe that women are less capable.
Yo.
And then
you sit here and pretend you're not biased and you're beyond biases is bullshit. That's the first thing. Okay. We're all biased.
Okay. And then like a natural, good, educated human being, you're probably going to go on the internet and find some study that maybe you're right about it. And then you're going to figure out that you're wrong.
Oh, yeah. The internet study. Oh, Why didn't I think of just following the internet study and not?
You're
think-
right, because we could have gone fucking taste experience instead.
Bro, why don't I ignore all my own personal experience and obey the internet study and get my fifth injection and just do everything the internet says?
You're right.
My personal experiences. Females are not capable of driving as males. That's my personal experience. You can't come along and tell me that's not true. So, and I don't give a shit, buddy. So
the next time we have a problem with science or some shit or physics, why go to the internet or talk to some experts? Let's go with ask Tate's experience on it, and we'll have the answer to it, right? Sorry, no insults. That was just I got unhinged over that.
It's fine. That's what Twitch does to people.
I'll give you that one. That's pretty true.
Conversation would be very different in person. Well, certain realities about the Earth, and in my personal experience, every car crash I've been in, every time my car's been hit, the worst parking I've ever seen has always been by a female. Now, I'm not saying females are bad people. I'm saying they're better than men at other things.
Okay.
Men have, if you want to talk about internet studies, because you seem to believe internet studies for some reason, even though you can give me lies, you can give me big lies, you can give me statistics.
Don't ditch Gallups, they're one topic at a time.
No, studies are the biggest lies on Earth, but if you want to talk about studies, it's been proven that females do not have the same kind of spatial awareness that men have. They do not have the reaction times that men have.
They've not evolved.
This has been studied and found. You want to talk about studies.
And
they have not
yet, males cause more crash accidents on the road than women.
Cool.
They have less tools to you and studies. Yes, so they cause more accidents, but according to your experience, they cause more accidents. So you're right.
Correct. And so we have studies that conflict. And in my personal experience, I feel safer when a man is driving me than if a woman is driving me. That's my personal experience. If you want to sit here hoping that if you keep saying women can drive, you might get a girl, that's your decision. But in my personal experiences, that's not the case. I don't know why we're going to sit here and argue about it.
Perfect. Then what you're saying is that since you're such a smart being, if you go to the casino and there's 60% red squares and 40% black ones, right? 60, 40. You should bet on the 40% black ones because that's how you're going to make money.
I don't understand a word you just said.
According to your analysis of these stats, right?
I don't truly understand the analogy.
And it's simple. It's very simple. Like I just said. According to your interpretation
of the stats on the internet or whatever,
right? You would bet on the 40% outcome instead of 60%. And you're saying this is a good bet.
Oh, bro. I know. And I mean this with respect. I know the internet is your life, right? I don't use the internet for stats when I get into a car with a bitch. I don't go and go, okay, well, she's blonde. Let me look up the blonde chicks. Can they drive? Da-da. I get in a car and I look at her driving and go, and this bitch can't drive. That's what I do, right? And any man who's honest with himself has been in the car with a chick who's driving on some wild ass, crazy, texting on her phone, risking everyone's life. Every man knows I'm telling the truth.
Okay.
I know you can't say it. Okay. You don't want to get kicked.
They can't fucking drive. They can't fucking drive. I don't say, I'm going to go to the study or I'm going to do this to Andrew Tate. They can't fucking drive. Let me break a little bit and fucking change lane, yo. You know, I don't have a license.
So why don't you ask Tate if you would say that about a race or something like that? A generalization like that.
Facts,
about a
rage.
Joke
Take
about
over
a race
rage.
Or ethnicity.
Rage
or
is being an alpha right now.
Hey, listen. Listen.
Could have asked him right now.
Let's understand my
question.
Let him talk.
So I'm half black, half white, right? That's my ethnicity.
Wait.
So we understand my ethnicity.
I made
a joke an hour ago with one of my cousins, because half my family's black, half my cousin's white, and he said he wanted to go free diving. It's where you dive down in the water and you go deep with no scuba equipment with the sharks or some shit. And I said, bro, that's what white people do, that shit. I'm too brown for that. I'm not going with the sharks. I just made a joke. There. Oh no. Cancel me. Who gives a fuck? When I make a statement, bro, listen.
Told you disagree with everything I say. So I'm just here to.
Yeah, most things. I mean, some of the motivational shit or whatever the fuck, it's like reiterated stuff that you hear on fucking billionaire self-help books or some shit, which are fine. I mean, I agree with a lot of them. I'm not going to fucking dick ride and say that I agree with the rest of them, because that's what people do, you know? You say a lot of true shit and you slip some dog shit in the middle and then people will take it as a truth, which is fair.
Well, I don't try and slip dog shit into my views. They're my views on my views, and they're based on my personal experiences, and I don't try and slip dog shit in. I don't attempt to do that on purpose. I don't think it's dick riding to agree with everything someone says either. I don't think it's dick riding to agree with people.
Thank you.
The internet's, like I said, I'm new to all this space. It's weird. It's a weird place. Like if I were to come along and say I 100% agree with all of the things that X-Man says, people are going to insult me for that. I don't see I'm not saying I agree with every single thing about his being, but the things he says on the internet, I may agree with all of them.
I also agree with that. I also agree that this new the thing of meta of saying, oh, dick ride or whatever, because you generally agree with all the takes. It just so happened to it. People say dick riding, that's fucking stupid. I also agree. Okay, I can add the lady if she's a paid actor. Do you think she's a paid actor?
Bitcoin? Bitcoin, you know what this? You don't have? I'm going to set you up because this baller here is going to send you $100,000. I know he wouldn't lie online.
I wouldn't lie. See,
oh,
he thinks.
He thinks he's capping. He thinks Shane's actually capping.
No, man, you have no idea.
I hope not. I hope not. Like, I would respect him very much.
He thought that I was fucking around trying to man up. I'll do it.
That would change her life, and I would love to see that. That would make me
happily,
very happy.
Baby. I got it. Set her up. Just make sure it's going to her, not you or anyone else. Please.
Bro, she's giving you great massages. Why don't you change her life, bro? Come on, man.
But do you have any family members or children who understand Bitcoin? Your children have Bitcoin? Nothing?
Bro, if you set her up an account and like cash it out for her and like somehow set up a bank, like I'll send extra just for that. Like if you have an assistant or someone that can do that, I'll happily take. Can you do that?
Yeah, I'll get someone on it now.
Add me on Discord. Add me on Discord. We'll get this done for her. I'm down.
All right. Awesome.
Yeah. How'd that happen?
So I was a kickboxer for a long time. I was fighting for money. There's not that much money in kickboxing. And then my first serious entrepreneurial. I mean, I ran lots of businesses. Did this. Did that. Something
like what?
You can't. Everything, man. I had a normal job for a while when I was kickboxing, and I did some different things, and I did some things I shouldn't have done, and blah blah blah, and was in jail for a little while, and got out, and then I opened up a webcam company. I had girls sitting on the internet talking to men, and I ended up scaling that up to having 75 women working for me. That's how I first made millions of dollars.
Fucking porn website.
Damn! What the fuck?
You don't know this story? This is like my most known story online.
You never told it to me.
It's a really long story, and I've told it. I've told it very, very well on some other podcasts. But the short version of it was, I got in some debt to some dangerous men, and I needed money fast. And I was sitting in my room trying to work out a way to make money, because at the time I was only fighting, and I didn't have a fight coming up for a while. And I was researching how money works. Like, I was trying to understand how money works, where it comes from. This is where I learned about the Federal Reserve and fractional reserve banking and all these things. So, interesting point he made earlier about, you know, the matrix and its currency and how it's all a lie. I understand all that very well. But that really made me mad, because now I understand money's bullshit and I still don't have any. And I was really upset. And I was sitting there with a piece of paper trying to write down my assets and my liabilities and, like, you know, trying to write down all the geek shit they tell you. And for assets, I wrote down that, obviously, you know, I'm strong, but I'm already fighting. I'm brave, but I'm already fighting. I had all these girlfriends, but I thought, well, I can't afford to open a strip club. I'm not going to put them out on the track. I'm not that kind of guy. They're my girls. And then I discovered by accident, when I was clicking around on these websites, I saw those things in the corner, you know, talk to live girls now. And I thought, well, my girls could do that. And long story short, I ended up with 75 women and 4 premises and making $1.4 million a month. And that's how it all started. That was about 10 years ago.
Wow. Holy
that's
shit.
The story. Yeah. That's, I mean, there's an in-depth version of it, but that's the story. And people listen to that and they seem to think that for some reason I was exploitative, but it's absolutely the opposite. I'm a feminist, bro. I empower women to make as much money as they want to make, and I help them do it. I'm here. And
as long as it's for you.
My name
right?
Fire
it's
a pimp.
He was
a pimp.
Hold on. So look, X, this is what I wanted to actually ask the question, because I know it was a question that you had. Hold on. Andrew, one of the takes that you made on my stream about that you should take 100% of, you know, your girls' OnlyFans. I know, X, you felt some type of way about that. Andrew,
I mean, they said that you were joking 100% and you weren't joking. So I assumed that you were joking, but I still hold this take that you weren't.
Well, it depends, right? So if it's a girl who were to come to me and say, Andrew, I would like you to help me make money on OnlyFans, and they would come to me for my marketing expertise, then of course it would be a fair deviation. I make 20%, 30%, whatever. That's different. But if it's my girlfriend, my long-term partner, and we're going to be together forever, and she decides to go down that particular career path, I think I should have a much larger stake, because she is my girl, and she is now giving away some of the most private and intimate parts of her body to the internet. Those parts of her body belong to me effectively because she's my woman. That's the whole point of being with somebody. So to be pretend she's going to do that and make a bunch of money and give me nothing is, I find that disrespectful. I would sooner tell her, look, you're not doing OnlyFans, and she would always.
So I called it then that you weren't actually joking. It was an actual true statement, right?
Yeah, if I had a serious long-term girlfriend and me and her are together and we're going to be together forever, and she says, I'm desperate to do OnlyFans, I say, you don't need to, we're rich. She goes, no, I really, really want to. I say, okay, the money's mine then.
We can dismantle these statements into one at a, like small rocks. We can approach them one at a time, right? Because there's a lot that, respectfully, okay? I think there's a lot of parts of that that are garbage, right? But I don't want to say something at the whole rock, and we have to do small rock pebble at a time, you know? Right? So... Cool. Also, this motherfucker can laugh over here. You see it next to me? Los Polos. He's laughing, but he said you were trolling, so you were joking 100%. But he's only a star right now, because he's going to be... Right? But he said you were wrong 100% about this, and so wrong that you were joking. So I don't know why he's only a star right now.
What did I do?
I'm just saying.
Very particular scenario, right? You have to understand that the scenario in which I would take 100% is a very, very particular one. In general, when I had my business, and I know you're saying that they only made money for me, they made money for themselves. I turned girls, I would actually sit here and say, as the biggest misogynist on this panel, I've turned more girls into multimillionaires than any of you. I've made girls multimillionaires. This is 10 years ago at the beginning of all this shit, before OnlyFans, when webcamming was new. I took girls from Starbucks and made them millions and millions and millions of dollars and paid them fairly, never missed a single paycheck.
Okay.
I'm as feminist as you can get. Now, yeah, I got...
Like I said, I don't... Okay, no disrespect once again. Okay, I just feel like this is like the type of argument that goes like, I have three friends that are black when making certain comments or whatever. So I don't... Unfortunately, don't get mad at me.
I'm mad at you.
Okay. Well, respectfully, I think that is genuinely the same vibe, energy comment, right? Oh, I can't be against women because I helped four or five of them. I'm not against women because I made a couple of them millionaire or whatever the fuck, right?
It's not about being against women. I'm saying that the whole was a net positive for both me and the females. So you misunderstood my point. You think I'm making a different point, and that's why you've come to that conclusion. The point I'm making is that everybody who worked for me won. The only person who lost was the guy sending his money away online. That's fine. But for everyone who was associated with me, both me, it wasn't exploitative because you made it sound like I only did it for me. No, the women who worked for me also made millions of dollars. Everybody who was associated won. Everyone won. All of them.
Yeah, for business activities or whatever. Yeah, that's fine. I don't think I wasn't talking about that at all. All I meant was okay. But fuck it. Let's just skip this tangent we're on. Just go. Let's just go back to the main argument you said. So I have more of a stake. So you think that in a relationship, you have a certain stake on your partner's income based on what that income comes from.
Well, depending on how they make it, absolutely. I think that in a relationship with a woman, if the man is with that woman, the main reason he knows he's with her is the fact that she is sexually exclusive to him. If you're with a woman and she's fucking everyone, are you even with her? No. How do you know she's even yours? Because she only sleeps with you, right? Well, if all of her intimate parts are now for everybody and they're purchasable, then I think you have a stake in said parts because those parts belong to you. She gives them to you when she decides to be a woman.
So there's a price that you're taxing your loss of privacy.
That's a way you could put it. I mean, personally, if my woman were to come to me and say she wanted to do OnlyFans, I'd just say no because I'm not.
Okay. Then.
But example. Okay.
Yeah, I mean, respectfully, let's try to upscale that discussion and see what kind of stake would you need for your girl to suck another guy's dick.
I would never tolerate that on any level. So that's too far. But
there's a price for the pictures and the loss of intimacy.
Correct.
It's a black and white thing.
For $1 million,
once you lose a certain amount, you can lose more of it.
Would you let your girl suck a dick?
I understand what you're saying. Yes or no? To me, it's not black. Because pixelated pictures on the internet are very different than sucking an actual dick. So I would never let my girls be prostitutes. None of the girls who ever worked for me ever prostituted. I've never associated with a prostitute. I'm not associated with porn stars. None of that kind of shit. But I had very wholesome girls with pictures of their titties on the internet 10 years ago who made themselves millionaires. Yes. And now they are happily married with somebody or whatever. Or some of them are still with me. It doesn't matter. But I was never... like getting girls to prostitute or hardcore pimping along that line. I use the word pimp because I had a lot of women who worked for me and they were all beautiful and it sounds cool. But truthfully, I don't even really see myself in that regard. I think I'm less of a pimp than most corporations. The girls who work for me, 50%. You don't get 50% of the cash register when you work at McDonald's.
Okay, they can also, people can be pimps and companies can be pimps to a certain level, right? Which doesn't has anything to do with you being a certain level of a pimp. I think I if your girl is doing something, an activity of her own will, I feel like taxing her is that's being a pimp, like, quite literally. You are pimping at the wazoo. Yeah, you are pimping.
I understand, but and maybe you've never had the kind of relationships I've had with my women, but any woman I'm with decides to, by her own free will, submit to me because she sees me as her intellectual superior. She sees me as her life superior. She looks up to me and she respects me, and she sees me as her. She sees me as. And for that reason, if she were to come along and say, do OnlyFans, and I said no, she wouldn't do it. But if she insisted on doing it, I would sit here and say, look, I'm unhappy with you doing this, making a bunch of money off of parts which are supposed to be intimate only for me. If this is going to happen, I need to have some kind of compensation for my unhappiness. Yes. And she would understand and she would pay me. But this is not a scenario I need to be involved in. This is just a hypothetical, right? But all the girls who worked for me, they were not romantically involved. They were girls who decided to make a bunch of money and they came to the best in the business, which was me. So let's swap the hypothetical. Let's say you're in love with a woman. She comes to you and she decides she wants to do OnlyFans. What do you say?
Okay, so I've had a lot of things about OnlyFans before. A lot,
bro. Answer the question.
I personally just because I think it's just gonna kind of annoying. I wouldn't go into it knowing she's doing it.
So right? You would. So if your girl came to you and said, no, your girl's not already on OnlyFans. You're with a girl and she's seen OnlyFans online. She decides she wants to start. She comes to you and says, I want to become an OnlyFans chick. You're going to say, yeah, go for it. Don't give me a penny. Go for it. Get rich. Show your titties. That's going to be your answer?
No, I just say, this is kind of annoying. It's an annoying thing. I don't fully agree with it. Right? So it'd be kind of cold. It's cold. I don't like it.
Well, this is the point. So I think it's you're and I understand this is really interesting what Train said earlier about internet language, because when you make a point, you have to be very, very careful with what you say. It's almost like politician speak. But you're saying it's annoying. I wouldn't like it. Well, I'd say you're not allowed. That's what I'd say. I'd say you're not allowed to be on OnlyFans if you're my girl.
Okay.
And if you are, you're.
Okay. The point I'm trying to make is that I don't like it. And if it escalates to a point, I guess I would break up. But that's not like the I don't think that's the main point though. What does that prove? I think it's just lame. It's generally lame.
Hey. All right. So the point I'm making here is that it's a situation that most men don't want to find themselves in. They're completely in love with the chick and she decides to do OnlyFans. We're in a hypothetical situation. Saying I'd break up with the chick is a boring answer. So assuming you have to stay with the chick, that's the parameters of the question to make the question interesting to answer. My answer is that I need to be paid for her to be doing OnlyFans. That's the answer in the hypothetical situation. Your answer in the hypothetical situation is it's kind of annoying. I don't know.
There are parameters to this. Yeah. There's a bunch of parameters around that. It would be like, I hope she's not doing it because of lack of fulfillment in certain ways in our relationship, because that's a fucking problem. I wouldn't want my partner to go to places because she's craving a part of something she isn't getting in our relationship. As long as something takes away from a relationship, right, and the framework remains the same, then I guess it's kind of chilling. But that's kind of how it comes to OnlyFans, because people do it for a lot of reasons and a lot of other ones. So it's kind of
Do you mind me asking you a question? How old are you?
26.
Okay, let me blow your mind, young man. Women love men they respect. And let me tell you this, and this is natural, this is evolutionary, it's biological. This is why women have certain even basic things like height, right? They're designed to be attracted to it evolutionarily because they respect larger men because they're more likely to be better at fighting, they're better warriors. Women fall in love with men they respect. Not even men they like that much. It's men they respect. Men they like are their friends. Men they respect are the ones they fuck. And let me tell you something. If a girl were to come to me and say, I am intent on doing OnlyFans, and I would say, I'm uncomfortable with you doing that. I don't want you doing it. She says, Andrew, I love you, but I'm going to do OnlyFans no matter what. I would have to put together parameters and a framework in which she still respects me as a man or we're over. It's not even about the money. It's about the fact that you are my woman. I love you, you love me, and you're going to show me enough respect as a man that if you're going to get naked on the internet, you're going to at least reward me in some way. There's not going to be all these men paying you money and you making a bunch of money on the fucking side sitting in my house without me getting shit, because that is disrespectful. And I would not allow her to disrespect me, not just because of my ego, but because of her own innate ability to not be attracted to somebody that she doesn't respect. If you were to come along and play things your way, if a chick were to come to you and say, I want to do OnlyFans, you'd say, well, I don't like it. It's kind of annoying, da, da, da. And she started doing it. She would fucking leave. The girl is more likely to stay with me taking all her money than she is stay with you keeping all her money. And that may not make sense to you, but one day you will understand.
A lot of that fake stuff they be saying, it just don't give you longevity. The qualities you need to look for in a female is whether she would give you her money. See, a chick could do a lot of things, man. But if she don't like you, she ain't gonna give you her money.
Okay. No. I'm gonna fire back at you and just say that, that whatever my relationship is lacking, whatever amount of respect that I'm losing, and whatever amount of privacy that I'm losing, you can't put a price on that. You can't revert that with money. You just can't do it. Can't do it. I want to feel fulfilled. And what fulfills me is that my desire is fulfilled. And we're both on that like equal mindset, right? And you can't exchange that with money in a transactional way. You just can't. It doesn't matter the amounts. Doesn't matter. It does make me fulfilled. So if the partner can make up for it, whatever they're doing that they're lacking and they're kind of like reverting it somehow towards me, I guess we can find some sort of compromise, right? But it wouldn't be about money or be transactional money-wise. It just wouldn't.
Brother, life is transactional, my friend. And to sit here and pretend that because things are transactional means there's no emotions involved isn't true. Life is transactional. If I'm completely head over heels in love with a woman and I love her with all my heart and I'm ready to take a bullet for her, it's still a transactional relationship. She still provides things and I still provide things that satisfy both of us. You do not sit here and stream for free. Life is transactional. So to sit here and pretend that things shouldn't be transactional is asinine. That's not the way the world works. Every single thing in the world is transactional. Even if I give money to charity, even if Train gives this lady who's massaging me $100,000, he's doing that one for clout, two because he gets to feel good about himself. It's not pure charity. He gets to win too. It's the same with me. There's Romania has an orphanage problem. A lot of orphans. Every single Christmas, I go down to the orphanage with the Rolls Royce, give $100,000, whatever. Am I the fucking nicest man in the world? Well, yeah, but also I feel good. I feel good for doing it, right? Yeah. So life is transactional.
Yo.
So to say here and see things shouldn't be transactional is asinine. That's not a right paradigm. You must view the world in a transactional sense. Yo, the world is transactional.
Yeah, but you're being a little bit obtuse though. You are deliberately obtuse about what the nature of how we use transactional as a term. You're just saying, oh, it's all transaction. Yeah, of course. Then everything in life, if it goes one way, it comes back to another way, that's transactional. So everything is. But that's not how we use the word transactional. Transactional is more of a, not an indirect, it's more of a direct thing. I'm doing this for that, right? That's how we normally use transactional. The way you're saying is just, oh, it's an exchange of brain chemicals. I'm doing this and I get this brain reward, right? As an exchange. That's kind of, that is obtuse.
Fine. Let me change the way I ask you the question, right? Because what I'm actually... And once again, you're only 26. You are smart. I can see you're smart, but you're 26. So if I were in your position and I had disagreed with everything that Andrew Tate had said, and Andrew Tate was going to come on a stream, first I'd have a list of everything he said I disagree with. You don't even have a list. So you haven't been very professional about your approach in this. You don't even know most of the things I've said. You're just saying this about, it's all very general. So in future, please.
Say that again. Sorry about that. I was fucking distracted by bullshit.
Fine. And fine. In future, make a list of all my points you disagree with so we can be more systematic in our approach.
The problem is that you're a Gish Galloper. You're professional at it. You're really good at doing it. Gish Galloping, you do dang, 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 and then it's kind of hard to catch up because once we talk about something, it's already too late.
Cool. Well, let me tell you what you're doing just so you're aware. If I walk into NASA and I say that going to space is too expensive and too dangerous, and they say, well, yeah, I agree with you. And I say, okay, this is bullshit. And I go, well, what's the alternative? And I cannot present an alternative. That does not make me a fucking physicist. That does not make me an astronaut. That makes me a jackass. So if you cannot propose a better alternative, then you have no point to make. And this is the point I'm making with you. The parameters of the question are you're in love with a woman who decides to do OnlyFans. You can't break up with her. And I have also added another parameter. You want to retain the respect and the authority in the relationship. You think that taking money in said situation is completely unreasonable and unfair. Fine. What is an alternative which is superior? And if you cannot name one, then it is the best of a bad choice. It may be an unfortunate situation, but it's the best move in a bad chess position, and you must still make the best move. If you have a better move to make, I'm open to hear it. But if I'm in love with a woman, and I'm not going to break up with her, and she comes with me, and she insists on doing OnlyFans, my answer to retain my control and my respect in my relationship is for her to pay me. That is my answer. If you have a better one, my ears are open.
Okay. Like I said... Whenever somebody does OnlyFans, it's because what does that come from? Like, it can be a lot of things of why they would do it. Only money or some sort of fulfillment or whatever, right? Some sort of fulfillment, right? If they're doing it because they're lacking something in the relationship, they're taking something away from the relationship, yeah, that's a fucking problem. I guess break up. If I'm that uncomfortable, I'm not going to put a price on that. I'm not going to be fulfilled in something and spend my entire life with somebody and be committed. There's no price you're gonna pay me to be deluded that we're at the same level of commitment. Break up. End of story. No alternative. One alternative, break up. If you're that uncomfortable, I will not put a dollar amount on that. I will fucking break up and move on. And the fact that you can put a price on your lack of commitment or whatever you think you're like, because if they make
but
it
it's
only
not,
fans,
it's not about the
fucking
money. It's
alarming.
The principle, chat, right?
Wait, so what he's saying was a hypothetical. He said in a real normal world, it's like, no, you just, we can't, no OnlyFans, we break up. It is what it is. What he's saying, there's no breakup in this scenario. No breakup. What is the alternative of the transaction?
No, and X.
Also, X, he's saying it's not about the money. It's the principle behind it.
His hypothetical is no, like in a situation where you guys aren't breaking up and it's just you need some. What are you gonna do instead?
I have hundreds of millions.
I said broke up.
Okay, cool. Okay. Well, the point is, I have hundreds of millions of dollars, and if my girlfriend did OnlyFans and made $2, she would pay me my dollar. And that's because it's principle. It's not
principle.
About the money.
Yeah.
Okay.
Bro.
Yeah. Still fair enough. But you can't, in my opinion, that the nature of that behavior of putting a dollar amount because of some lack of what
it's
the
not
fuck
about the
is
fucking
stupid.
Money.
It's an alarming logical conclusion. It's just bad.
What else about me do you find alarming?
No, I'm just saying it's alarming. That's it.
Okay. What else about my views or things you've heard me say or my attitudes or my life approach?
Oh,
do you
my girl can't go out. That's fucking alarming as shit.
My girl can't go out?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's discuss this. All right, cool. So I take my girlfriends out all the time, right?
Cool.
But if my girl were to say, I want to go out with seven other girls to the club, in my personal experience, I'd be unhappy for her to do that because I've been the man in the club that those seven girls turn up to and end up on his table, and I know what happens. I've lived a very, very long life. I know how that ends. Now, okay. I discussed that if I'm going to be in a relationship and I'm going to have responsibility over a woman, which I want to have because it's my masculine imperative, I should also have a degree of authority that comes with that responsibility. If I'm responsible for her safety, for example, but she refuses to obey me when I say don't walk home in the middle of the night, then how can I truly be responsible? Responsibility and authority are linked. I'm responsible for her because I'm her man and I take the best care of her. I might know things she doesn't know. She might be 19 years old and think going to the club's all fine. I'm 35. I've been around. I've seen what happens in clubs. No, you don't need to go there. I'm responsible for you. I take care of you. And by extension, I have authority to say to you, you're not going to that nightclub. That doesn't make me crazy. It doesn't make me insecure. It doesn't make me weak. She can always say I'm going to go anyway, and that's fine. And then we can break up. But in my scenario, any woman I'm serious about is going to obey me. And I'm not going to come along with some crazy, maybe people will call it crazy. I'm not going to make her do anything wrong. She ain't going to take drugs. She's going to go to the gym. She's going to eat right. She's going to be learning shit. And she ain't going to be in the club sniffing and drinking. Now, if that makes me a bad person, then so be it. No problem. But I get plenty of girls who sign up to that all day long without problems. And any man who sits there and goes, I'm not insecure, I'll send my girl to the club. Send her to my table, G. Send her to my table. No problem. Send her.
Okay.
We'll talk about insecurity when she's sucking dick.
Okay. Yo. Then, according to your mindset and how you see things then, and your high levels of security apparently, right? If your girl was to go to the club, right? And I was at the club, you're scared that I will bring your girl home.
I don't live in fear. It's not about scared because I don't live in fear.
That's fear.
No, it's not fear.
What is the outcome that you do not want of her going to the club?
I'll explain. I'm a terrorist.
Guys coming over and bringing her home. You, by fear, you are scared of her going home with another guy. That is a move that is literally fueled by fear. You are fearful.
That's an interesting viewpoint, and I know you think that that's relevant, and I know you think you've made a good point, but I'm about to dissect it and show you.
Go ahead.
I'm a territorial individual, and I think that being a man, one of the best things about being a man is being territorial, being able to say, that is mine. That's the whole point of it. So let's use an analogy. And please, when I make this analogy, I don't want you to try and get caught up in the analogy because I'm about to compare a woman to a car. Do not say, you're comparing women to cars. That's low IQ. This is just an analogy. If I go outside, right? Or let's say I have a Lamborghini. I have many cars, but let's say I take my Lamborghini. Would I park it in a high crime area? Even if the locks are fantastic, even if my woman is loyal and completely and utterly in love with me, and I know there's 0% chance any man could ever take her home because she's with the top G, which is the case. Even if I know the locks on my car, it has bulletproof glass, it's locked, you can't break into it. Will I park my Lambo in an area where people are going to try and steal it?
No, I won't, because
that is irresponsible. So the fact is, I don't care if men try and come up to my chick because no one can steal my chick because I am me. The fact is, it's irresponsible for me to put her in a scenario where people will attempt it. If I walk out to the car park and someone's trying to break into my car, even if the locks to my car are secure, I will still decimate said individual for attempting to steal my property. That's what it's about. It's about territorialism. It's not about being fearful the girl's going to run off with someone else. There's nowhere to go but from me but down. It's not about that.
Fair
it's about the fact that it's irresponsible for me to put her in that scenario. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I mean, the argument would be good. If I were you, I'm making that argument. I could rationalize the argument you just did. If most of the girls that I dated or that I was with had the IQ of somebody who cannot move, think, or do anything, and is just stuck on the side of the fucking curb.
He said decimate.
So yeah, I guess maybe you would have this experience if Moses did were zero IQ, brain frozen. Yeah, but it doesn't make sense in the real world because you don't park your fucking girl on the curb at the club. They move, they talk, they do shit. It's not a fucking. It's not the danger of other guys doing shit, right? Because they can still think. And the loss of potential that one guy out of a million will do some crazy shit and is going to forcibly bring her home, right? Is far outweighed by the fun and enjoyment and fulfillment that they get by going to the club in the first place.
That's interesting. But you also have to understand, because we are different individuals living very different lives, and I'm not going to sit here and comment on your relationships because I don't understand them, because I don't know them. But you have to understand. Now, I am at a status of life where any woman who gets with me understands that to be with a man of my caliber, there are certain sacrifices which must be made. You do not get to be with a kickboxing world champion, multimillionaire, whose entire life is completely on track and live a life of spoiled princess, and then also say to that man, I go to the club whenever the fuck I want. You might be able to say that to some other men, but you can't say it to me. So, and I want to say something to you that you may not yet understand once again, because you are intelligent, but you're not yet wise because you are young. Women are malleable. And when I say they're malleable, people think that women are these individualistic, unique creatures. And they are to a degree, but they are heavily molded by the man they're with. You'll notice if a woman gets with a man and she loves him, she likes the same music he likes. The same
Anybody's in that regard. Everybody's malleable in that regard with the people that they're with, people that are around. People are the fucking result of what's around them. That's just...
Correct. So women are malleable. So a woman which may say to you, I'm a unique, special snowflake, I do whatever the fuck I want, if she was in my presence, she wouldn't say that. Now, because women are a reflection of their man. It's not hard to get a woman who sits there and says, you know what, I don't go to the club without my man because I adore my man. If the man is worthy of such adoration, if the woman's sitting there going, well, I'm with him, but no, he doesn't tell me what to do, that's the man's problem. It's nothing to do with the woman. Females are all the same. It's all about the man they're with. I have no trouble and no arguments in my life telling women they don't go to the club by themselves. Zero. It's not a conversation that even ever appears ever because I am me. So for you to sit here and describe scenarios, that's fine. And you're saying that my women are low IQ. I would counter that by saying if I was the same women you were with, they'd behave better for me than they would for you. And that is because of my status and my wisdom and my individuality that you've yet to.
You treat and pay for them like they're Lambos that are parked at the curb. Of course they're going to be like this if you want to go down that argument. So yeah, I guess once more, I have to concede the point because you're right. I guess you dated frozen Lambos parked at the curb.
It's not frozen Lambos. Saying to a woman,
I mean, that is what you compare. That is your example. You compare the behavior and the potentials of her being stolen to a parked Lambo. Therefore, right. I have to use that analogy when talking about the girls that you are dating.
Saying.
And
he
you are
right.
I'm sorry. It's not an insult. You made this precedence. I have to use it.
Yeah.
I will take any woman I could date. Any woman I don't know who your girlfriends are. I don't have a clue. But any woman you've ever dated, if I was with her, she wouldn't be going to the club without me. That's the bottom line. And that's because who I am. The woman's paradigm, the idea that the female is going to come along and demand to only go club with the girls, et cetera, that is heavily dependent on the man she is with.
So what makes you above her then? The money, the status, the top G. What is the label or the prerequisite that makes you above her?
It's not about being above. It's about her.
Yes, it is.
It's about her respecting me.
Therefore, you can't go to the club either. You don't go to the club then.
That's bullshit. I go to the club whenever the fuck I want.
Okay, then what makes her unable to go to the club if you can't go to the club if you're equal?
I am responsible for her, and I have authority.
Why are you responsible? What makes you responsible?
I'm responsible for her because I am more competent as an individual. Now, before
how do you know that? All the girls. And there's no girl out there that could be above you. You're above everybody else.
Well, let's because I know you're gonna try and go down the sexist argument. Let's reverse it.
Well, I mean, you bait it. Okay, listen. You have driven this conversation since the beginning. I gave you the initial roots argument or point, and you are driving yourself there.
Cool.
And so you are drawing a circle around it. I didn't do shit.
All right.
I said, what makes you above her? And you're not giving me an answer.
It's not about being above. It's about having responsibility for.
So why don't you share responsibility?
Okay, because you can't share responsibility because nothing in life is 50-50. There's always, even if it's 49%, 51%.
Okay. Then why you?
Me, because I'm me. This is the exact point. Now let's reverse it, which I've been trying to do for the last 30 seconds. There are women out there who are with men, and that man needs her to tell him, stop playing video games, stop smoking weed, go to the gym, get your diet in order. Why don't you ever work? Why ain't you got any money? There are millions of relationships out there. In said scenario, she has responsibility because she's his mother and she tells him what to do, and she has authority. She can tell him not to do shit because she's the fucking boss. That is happens. It's not about a sex thing. It's about human dynamics and every relationship. Someone's in charge, and I'm in charge of my relationships, and I find it irresponsible of me to put her in a scenario where something could happen to her.
But you,
carry on.
Sorry to interrupt you. I just figured what a good point was. I can interject. Since you're making that point, right? The problem with these statements is that you say girls. You always say girls or my girls, right? Intending that it's all of them. What about some girl, right? Right now, hypothetically, is a multi-trillionaire, right? And is in your kitchen right now, and she comes away right now. The door opens behind you. We see a little glint of light right behind you right now. And he says, hey, Tate, get the fuck off the computer, drinking his bullshit with his stupid cigar, talking to that fucking devil on your computer, right? That could happen, right? According to you. No, it can't happen. Why not?
It can't happen, and I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why. Because you said some girl being a multi-trillionaire. There's plenty of women in the world who may have a lot of money.
Yeah.
But you have to understand that when you look at life, you have to look at life in the different paradigms. There's many different lenses you look at life through. And when you look at life from a societal perspective, yes, women are equal to men and they should be, fine. But when you look at women from an animalistic perspective, because we are basically animals, they are not equal to us physically. When it comes to something like personal safety, which a club involves a lot of, they can get spiked, a man can try on with them and lose his temper, they can get attacked, whatever can happen. When it comes to physical protection, that is a man's realm. You could be a UFC world champion, female, whatever. I'm too big and I'm too strong. I'll still beat him. So there's no female alive who's going to come into a room and tell me when it comes to things like personal protection, responsibility for her own personal safety, etc., trump my views. That's not true. I'm a man. I have certain domains in which I rule.
Okay. Then in this line of argument with the things that you just said, I'm trying to go one by one. So I have to be selective about how I'm doing this. Okay. What you're saying, since you brought up the fact that you can get spiked, is that you, Andrew, if you go at the club alone, because the girl is staying at home, she has to stay home, she's boxed in. You go to the club because you're such a fucking warrior, and you get spiked heavier than you're drinking, you drink it, you will not go unconscious because you're such a fucking lion, aren't you?
It's not about that. It's about the fact that if the woman was with me in the club or if the woman couldn't protect me, that's not the woman's domain. It's down to me and my team to protect me. The female has absolutely no say when it comes to things like personal safety. She has no domain.
So she can't have a team around her. She can't.
A team of chicks? A team of chicks?
Of anybody.
You send your girl to the club.
Did I say chicks?
Oh, a team of dudes. Cool. You want to send your girl to the club with a bunch of dudes. Cool. Your prerogative. Enjoy. Hope you have a nice, long relationship.
Yo.
My relationship will be long and fulfilling. I can't say the same to when you treat people like this. I mean,
saying that you don't go to the club without me, we'll go together? Oh, I'm the worst man in the world. Oh, no, don't take your girl to the VIP table with you. Oh, don't do that, Andrew, you misogynist. Send her out there with all those other dudes. I'll tell you what, bro. 87 professional fights, 4-time kickboxing world champion. How about this? I'll protect your chick. Send her to the club with me.
Bro, you can be the...
Why? You're trying to disprove me using exceptions in very, very unique scenarios. I'm sitting here saying people are born with two eyes, and you're saying, no, some people are born with one eye. Yeah, that's true. But in general... When you say someone, how many eyes does someone have? You say two. Now, if someone asks me how many eyes does someone have and I say two, and you were to run along and go, I know someone with one eye. That does not make me fucking wrong. So you're just trying to use exceptions to disprove rules, and it doesn't work that way.
Damn, he's good.
Any woman who's with me, in general, if you were to ask her, does she go clubbing? The answer would be no. I'm Andrew's girl. I don't go to clubs without Andrew. Now, are there very particular scenarios in which perhaps if a movie premiere and she's A-list and she has to go to a club for 15 minutes with security and I pick her up? Yeah, sure. That's not the point we're fucking making. Any woman who's with me doesn't go to the club. And the most important point of all of this is she doesn't want to. I don't have to stop her.
Okay.
All right, yo, X and Tate, listen, can we get to this next topic? The having a girl, having a guy best friend.
If you disagree with the girl having visual or aura contact with other male beings that are in the vicinity, clearly she cannot have a best friend. I mean, a friend, an acquaintance, bitch. Mother, a sight of fucking real life men pixel is a fucking breach that takes fucking insecurity. So I don't know.
I'm not insecure. What? Territorial.
That is insecurity. It, by definition, not allowing the girl to be around the sight of other men is insecurity.
I think you meant in a club scenery, but I'm just going to ask Andrew, can your girlfriend have a guy best friend?
No.
Okay. So, yeah, see, it's gonna be the all or most against, it's gonna be like the all against most take or all against whatever fucking take, you know, we're gonna go down again like last time. Whatever. Let's say, I can use a close example, okay? This girl does projects for Twitch events or fucking stream events. His name is Cutie, okay? Just an example, okay? I see her at a bunch of events. We work on projects together, I guess, right? I never fuck her.
Yeah, that's right? Acquaintance. That's not work. We're talking about friendship.
Well, I mean, she's still a friend, though.
No, she's an acquaintance. She's someone you work with, someone you know. I wouldn't call him a friend.
So, okay, it's not mutually exclusive.
It's hard to draw the line. But my point is that I don't think that when a woman and a man are purely just friends without, let's say, a financial...
Yeah, shall other debate topics, y'all.
Purely just friends. I don't think that's a platonic relationship. I think the man is interested in her most of the time. And when people disagree with me that, I say, then why do all the hot girls have so many friends and all the ugly girls don't have any? The men are trying to get laid. And for her to sit there and entertain it and pretend that that's not the case. Oh, no, he's just my friend. She knows what's going on. It's bullshit.
X, I have a question. Sorry to interrupt. Someone asked.
I mean, because you can reverse that.
X.
What?
Somebody had asked X if would you be okay if your girlfriend was best friends with Andrew Tate?
Well, I don't want any of my friends being friends with Andrew Tate. Andrew Tate is a fucking moron. No, I'm just kidding.
You're a famous Twitcher, bro. We could get a lot of pay-per-views on a boxing match anytime.
Bro. Have you seen these sticks I got? These are sticks. I can't fight with that. Bro, I did one tap. I'm still not scared saying that. It's like, I don't know. It's like, something comparable. It's like if I said, best, biggest fucking UFC fighter, Colossus, fucking 7 foot Andy. I mean, he's going to clap you too. It's all a matter of scale.
Would your mother hang around with some dude behind your father's back and say he's her friend?
Would your mother say that again?
I'd appreciate if you'd stop using the word fear, because I'm not fearful. So you can stop using that word, firstly. Secondly.
Well, I can't. It's hard, because when you don't want somebody to do something, it's out of fear. That's just how it is.
You think?
Yeah, by default it is, but you are fearful of something happening, yes.
It's not about being fearful. It's just about having my boundaries as an individual and having...
Boundaries of what? Boundaries that... What will happen? Boundaries of what? What is the thing that you're shielding? You said boundary... From what? Boundary and shield from what? From something. You don't wear a fucking bulletproof vest being scared of the fucking wind. You wear bulletproof vests against guns and bullets, bitch. Sorry. I take the bitch back. I cannot pull that.
I don't mind. If you're only with a woman because she is loyal, kind, soft, adoring, and beautiful, and she makes you feel happy, are you shallow?
I said it again. That was a lot.
She's loyal. She's adoring. She's funny. She's gorgeous. She makes you feel happy. Your friends love her. She lives in your house. She cooks. She cleans. You feel good when you're around her. Are you shallow to be with that woman?
No. Why would I be shallow?
Oh, so if a woman's only with you or me or anyone else because she looks up to you and sees you as strong, rich, competent, interesting, you can protect her. She likes to be guided by you. She likes talking to you. Is she shallow to be with you because you're purely high status?
No. So no, the point I'm making is that, I agree with you.
No, that's just one of the reasons she loves me.
Okay. It's all about proportions. Is that lady billing you a new fucking back and rearrange your fucking bones? Why is it being massaging for a full hour straight, bro? What is she doing out there, man? Bro, what the fuck? There's gotta be some sort of fucking osteopathic replacement or some shit.
I have a lot of muscle. It's painful to carry around. It's a 2 hour massage.
Bad proportions. Okay, think about it. Like I said earlier, the motherfucking polygon. Okay,
Jack,
if it's a polygon, it fills on certain sides because of certain strengths. Okay, what I'm saying is that you can have a little bit of everything, right? A little bit of everything. But if the reason why she's there is mostly the things that are fucking tangible, right? Like money or whatever. If most of it is that it's the money and the status or whatever, that's a fucking problem. Sure, you want to be a nice balance.
Like, I'm zoning out. Somewhat I'm too tired. Of everything. I wanna lock in,
so it feels fulfilling in all ways and good and feels good. It's a good thing. All the so if it goes with you because of 3% whatever, 3% intellect, 5% whatever, and then 40% money and 30% looks. What happens if your investment all fall flat and you get old in 10 years? Then you, that woman, out the window. You get, because the most reason why she likes you, most reason is these tangible dog shit, and then boom, it's gone.
Agreed.
And then what? What do you do then?
Then you're going to find another bitch. I never said that wasn't the case. what do you want me to say? I never said that wasn't the case at all. I'm saying that women are attracted to tangible things. It's a tangible world. I said this earlier. Now, I've never been with a woman who only loves me for money. I'm not a sugar daddy. I'm not like that as a person. I have a lot of money, but my women who are with me, they don't get like presents and cars, none of that shit. Like, they can live in the house and I'll take them out for dinner, but they could get with a man with less money than me and get a lot more money out of said man. So I understand the point you're making. Yeah, if a hooker's with a dude purely for money and he runs out of money, yeah, cool.
And how do you know that?
I know that because of how my relationship's set up. Because if they're with me for money, they choose someone else because they don't get any money.
Well, I mean, they're not to work, they're not to do shit. They live for free. So how do you know they're not with you only because they can live for free and a good life and a very fancy life? How do you build that framework, right, where they display they're with you for all these other intangible things from you that isn't only life stability and status?
Good question. Good question. So what we need to do is we need to get this Twitch stream. We need to get every single stay-at-home mother, every single stay-at-home wife in the entire country, and we need to ask them how we know they really love their husband. They're not just with them, so they don't need to have a job. Let's do that, shall we? That doesn't even make sense.
I didn't ask these fucking degenerates or me. I asked you.
Of course, she gets water. She works hard. She's here every day. She loves me. She's fine. She's my best friend.
Okay,
she's good. Well looked at.
What's her name?
Watch out. Hey, sorry, lady. You better watch this guy's girlfriend. She's about to get jealous because he has a best friend that isn't her. Holy shit. Why? Watch the fuck out. Hey, somebody tell her.
I want to say one more thing that will really trigger you, but this is true. All the rules I've been saying and all the things I've saying that apply to women don't apply to me. I can go to the club when I want. I can have as many female friends. So I can do whatever I want. So let's just make that. Okay. I can do as much as I want. I'm the boss.
You're the boss.
So I can do the fuck I want.
Top G.
Right? So, okay. Yeah, top G, my chick can't come to me and say, who's this chick? Like, some bitch. Why are you talking to her? Because I fucking want to. I'm allowed.
Well, I mean, in a way, when you have these two things, right? These grand, in that polygon, when you have a crazy
amount
of money.
Dick eating, I mean, chat. Am I dick sucking?
I mean, you can do whatever the fuck. You can do crazy, outlandish shit and still have security.
It's true, but I don't like people thinking that women are only with me for money because it's actually the absolute opposite. I only first ever made serious money because I had so many women when I was broke. So let's keep that in mind, firstly. So I had women when I had no money. So
and why? Because you were good looking or other things? What was it?
I was a world champion.
Because you had good hair? What happened when you went bald? You think maybe some women was only because of your hair? But now you're bald. What happened then?
I'm not bald. I shaved my head. I could grow all my hair back if I decided.
Bro, we can see the hairline. It's like a whole McDonald's symbol.
It's here. But it's because I was a world champion fighter, I'd assume, and because I'm interesting and smart, I guess.
That was funny, XQ.
I'm big. You and your woman are asleep in bed upstairs. You hear someone break into the house downstairs. Who goes downstairs?
Nobody.
Tripping. XQ, you tripping. Hold on, XQ, so you're not going down there?
Nobody's going down there.
So what if they come upstairs?
Bro, you gotta protect.
Bro, hold up, keep it $150.
Protect.
Real quick.
Real quick.
I'll keep it $150.
No. My job is to survive, not protect. My job is to survive, and sometimes that means to go down there. The guy's a gun. It doesn't matter.
That's not very courageous of you, bro.
We are both going down by doing the smart thing, the analytical thing, the strategic thing. We can both survive. If I go down, not only am I jeopardizing myself, I am jeopardizing both of us by not being smart and a leader in that regard. We are even more in danger if I go down than if I not go down.
But you're hiding, though. You're hiding.
So?
Like, you gotta try to protect your girl.
What?
Why is that crazy?
Bro, you are losing your... You live in America, right? No, you're losing your mind. Okay, my job
if
is not to protect.
If someone breaks into my house, I'm
my job
them.
Is
I'm
to survive.
Yeah, but in the scenario we're describing, you're upstairs, you hear someone break in, your girl turns to you and goes, someone's in the house. One of you has to go downstairs.
Why? Why do you go downstairs? Why do you go there? Why do you have to go down there? Why?
If you don't believe you have any kind of intrinsic masculine duty to at least attempt to protect your female, then that explains why we disagree on every single point.
Yes, I'm going to give you further than that. I even have an even higher duty to not protect her, to not even protect myself. I have a duty to fucking survive.
Survival technique. I renounce violence. I have a future.
It means if somebody breaks into the house, if somebody breaks into the house, he is more likely than not likely to have a certain tool to get in or a weapon. If I do not possess that weapon, right, I am not going down there with bare hands. We will both die.
You can have a weapon. I'm not saying you don't have a weapon. I'm saying.
And then you break it down. Another fucking argument like that, bro. You need to stop doing that.
I'm breaking it down.
You look at what do you have and what is the most likely to happen, and you choose the most favorable outcome for both parties to live. Whether that's running, whether that's hiding, whether that's like going to the ceiling, it's anything that we will do to stay alive, just like the animals do. If they cannot fight with weapons they don't have or tools they don't have, they run. It's called fight or flight. It's whatever is the best tool survive.
You're making very simple questions complicated. Let me change the question.
Twice.
You're upstairs. No, it's not. I'm changing the question because your answers are stupid. So I'm doing you a favor.
Bro.
Your answer is stupid, bro, because everyone knows that you have a duty to protect your woman, and you're pretending you don't.
I don't agree. I don't. Not even a little bit, bro.
Well, then perhaps you are a coward, but let me give you the last chance.
I survive.
No, hold on, guys.
If somebody in this hypothetical, if somebody has to deal with the threat and engage, if someone did, between you and your female partner, who would be the person who decides to deal with the threat? You or the girl?
I think that's irrelevant.
Yeah, it's irrelevant. Whoever can have the best outcome of fixing that with it can even both at the same time. If it's cooperation.
It's irrelevant. Who?
What if I have a gun, I go to the back, and I make her, and I'll go open the door, and I blast them.
So you win. Good, fine. That answers the question. I'm just trying to reverse.
I'm pretty bad at shooting, let's say. I open the door, then she shot. Am I still the man?
I'm trying to make you guys understand.
Well, no. I'm trying to make you understand. Am I still good now that I opened the door and then she shot? Or is that not good enough?
That's fine, but that's not going to hide here together. He would have been mocked forever. That's insanity. Somebody has to engage, and it's the man's job. Just like the men stay on the Titanic, the men go to fight. That's a man's imperative. And I don't care. Doesn't matter that I can fight. If I'm outnumbered 10-1 and they have machetes and I'm going to lose, fine. To provide or look after that female, which is why you have no frame in your relationship, which is why she doesn't obey you. You send her ass to the club to get fucked by somebody.
Okay, Tate.
Conversation. I've wasted enough of my life.
No.
Balls, let me know. But to sit here and talk to a man who thinks he can send his chick downstairs to fucking engage armed men, I know I'm wasting my time.
To be fair.
Okay.